This is not going to prevent every single incident, but it's going to make it a lot harder for 18-year-olds to purchase these delivery devices and redistribute them to younger kids they're in contact with in high school and college.
And that is Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, who is proposing legislation to raise the tobacco age, the minimum age to buy tobacco, from 18 to 21. I'm Robert Lang.
Bipartisan legislation, Robert.
It's bipartisan legislation. What surprises me a bit is they grow tobacco in Kentucky.
But Senator McConnell, as he said, introducing the bill, that they are trying to work away from tobacco. And like we did here in Maryland, through the tobacco settlement, back when I was in the legislature, we were graduating people from tobacco into other products, and farmers could make as much money. Here's my problem, Robert, with this whole concept. And by the way, the Senator Tim Kaine, a Democrat from Virginia, is a co-sponsor of this. Look, if e-cigarettes, which are the main driver of this legislation, Centers for Disease Control has seen an over 30% increase in teens smoking with e-cigarettes after smoking overall was going down, right? If that's the problem, then make e-cigarettes illegal. What are we doing? I mean, it's the same argument I had when they kept raising the cigarette tax every year. If this is such a harm to the health of individuals, why are we continuing to get revenue from it? Just make it illegal, and they refuse to do that.
There is the sense of diminishing returns when you raise the cigarette tax, but even the advocates for it say it deters people from smoking. It's a good deal.
Yeah, sure. We had seen, and I've made this argument the whole time, Robert, with Vinnie DeMarco and others who have been pushing this in Annapolis
Vinnie
for
DeMarco
many years.
Vinnie DeMarco is one of those who's told me
absolutely,
that.
Yeah. Is that traditionally we saw 50 million Americans over three decades continue to smoke. As others would leave, young people who were entering legal age to smoke would enter. We saw a level of 50 million Americans smoking for about three decades. We have seen a little leveling off in the last decade or so. But I'm just saying to you, Robert, that taxing this or raising the age doesn't go with the argument they're making. If this is a health issue, which is what they're saying it is, make it illegal.
All right. I want to turn to another subject. Story that broke while you were on the air this afternoon. Baltimore City Police Commissioner Michael Harrison named two key appointments. Michael Sullivan, the deputy chief from Louisville, Kentucky, to head the Operations Bureau, the deputy commissioner. And Michelle Wilson is going to be the first civilian to serve as a deputy commissioner, heading the Public Integrity Bureau.
Right.
She's an assistant attorney general, but she was in the news earlier this year.
Correct.
She was a key witness in a lawsuit that was filed against Marilyn Mosby.
Called her a liar.
Called her a liar in this lawsuit filed by one of her former deputies. This is an interesting hire.
Well, here's the thing. Three of Commissioner Harrison's top people are civilians. And people are looking at her now heading up this integrity unit. She's going to be head of the integrity unit, the police department, as very interesting. And whether or not this is a signal to either State's Attorney Mosby or others that there's going to be kind of a different approach in the police department. As you know, we're going to have Baltimore City Police Commissioner Michael Harrison on tomorrow in our special 7 to 9 p.m. We look at Baltimore's path forward in terms of violence. But I like the moves this commissioner is making, Robert. If you bring more civilians, this guy is from Louisville, the other gentleman that he brought in. I'm giving him a chance. I want to see exactly how he implements this.
All right. And don't forget that Project Community special airs tomorrow night at 7 o'clock in C4. We'll talk more about that tomorrow. And the C4 show is back tomorrow 9 to 1 on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.